Hello everybody, it's Brian with you from the Game Common, and we're playing some more Total War Warhammer. We are continuing with our Bretonnia Let's Play, and we're pulling things back. That freaking hard start is slowly starting to turn back in our direction. We still have Beastmen army up here that we have to worry about, but we did destroy Mussolini, or however you say it, so we no longer have to worry about the vampires over here. So the biggest issue we're going to have is, A, we got to kind of get control going on in Lyonnais, because right now the control is absolute crap. But we do have armies in both of these towns, and it's at -7 right now, but we do have the -10 conquest penalty, and the corruption's actually going down. Although, why is the chaos corruption going up? That makes no sense. Why is the chaos corruption going up? Either way, well, at least the vampire control is going down. The corruption is hurting us a little bit. We also had -5 provincial instability for one more turn, I guess? Huh. Oh, no, -1 per turn. Wait, it's going down per turn? Or it's going from -5 to -4 to -3? I don't know, I'll have to figure that out. But now that we have the vampires done with, we're going to want to turn our eyes to Marienburg and actually finish them off so we can have complete control of this province, and then we're going to pretty much be feeling pretty good about our life. At that point, I don't know what we're going to have to do, because like Baston and Bordeleau and stuff like that, we're going to want to like faction. We're going to want to get them to join our faction, and none of them are really willing to do that yet, join Confederation. Although I don't think I have the tech to do some of them. I can only do it with Lyonnais, which I did in Artois. So I do need to look at getting these heraldries. Unfortunately, we're still researching this decree, which doesn't really help me anymore. Should I switch it then? Does it continue? I think we will. Let's do Baston. Okay, let's see who's who. Baston is right here. Artois is there. Bordeleau is down there. So the next ones we can do are either Baston or Paraval. I don't know where Paraval is. Am I saying that right? Paraval? Have I even met them? I don't even think I've met them yet. Huh. So, yeah, let's do Baston for now. What is this one? Plus Dwarf Realms, plus Empire Provinces. Oh, that's nice. Then that's just going to be Carcassonne. Okay, and then Bordeleau. We do want to get to Bordeleau. Maybe Paravon died. You know, I think actually that happened. I think Paravon got killed. I think that was Paravon. Whoopsie. Oh, well. That's fine. We'll go... Oh, no. There they are. They're right there. Never mind. I really wish Artois would join my side, though, because that would really give me a leg up, I think, when it comes to money and everything like that. The other thing I wanted to do really quick in diplomacy as I was looking is the Empire. We should be able to get military access, and that's just going to slowly improve their relations with me. And they already like me a lot. I would like to get a military alliance with them. I'm slightly concerned that once we take Marienburg, they're going to, you know, because we're going to be neighbors with them at that point, they're maybe not going to like me as much, but we're going to have to see. So anyways... I don't know why I'm coughing so much today. Ah, there's our beastmen. We do have walls. Pretty much all our cities have walls except Mussolini that we just took over. So feeling okay about that. He is raiding Lyonnais. Yeah, that is somewhat unfortunate. God, he's taking freaking 363 freaking gold from me. Oh, so I need to take this guy and move him over there. What are we doing right now? We're at plus 11. Okay, so let's do this. We're going to move you out. And we're going to move you over in there. And we're basically going to switch cities with you guys. So we can have our big army right there.
Do you know who I am?
Do you know who I am? So the next turn I can go kick their butt. And we'll be at pretty much full strength at that point. If he goes for Lingual, I may just have to rush. I don't know. Yeah, because I can't actually have... I don't know what I'll do. I don't think he'll go up that way, though. He's probably going to run away, though, now that I have my giant force right next to him. Does he even have a hero? He does have Legendary Lord. But he's rank 1, so... These all look like low-level dudes, so I'm not really concerned at all. I'm more concerned with the fact that he's stealing all my freaking money. Gosh. We still have the trade... -80% trade agreement tariffs, but that's only one more turn, so... Life's going to be really good after this. I would hope. After we kill this guy and we get rid of that, we're going to feel really good about life, I think. You guys are positive. You guys are going positive. You are gaining control. So we're doing pretty good there. We can't afford to build anything right now, so we're just going to keep advancing turns for now. Got to keep this a shorter episode. I can't really afford to do 50-minute episodes all the time. Marienburg wants to peace out, probably? No, we're not at war with them. What do you want? Which you don't have. Non-aggression pact. Hell no, dude. I'm gonna freaking come declare war on you. piss off. So, they have dudes up here, but they're not raiding me. The chaos corruption has stopped. Well, it's still going 0.7, but it's, yeah. I need someone to level up so I can actually lower corruption. Actually, what I really need to get is a hero so I can lower corruption. Valiant. Unfortunately, I'm pretty sure there's no ability to purchase a hero. Oh, we can. We just don't have enough gold. We can actually get a paladin now. Why can't we get a paladin? Insufficient funds. So next turn, we'll actually be able to pick up a paladin. And I think that is going to be a really good thing for us. How do I do paladins? What building did I do that allowed me to get paladins? So the rank 2 stables allowed me to get a paladin. I didn't even realize that. Okay, so that's pretty good for us. So we want to pick up a paladin next turn so we can send him over here to help with the corruption. I think I am going to leave you over here. I could run him to Lingual, although we're losing. Why are we losing now? Because of corruption? I think because the chaos dude's over here. Or the beastmen. I think the beastmen are corruption. And I think that's why we're suffering so much corruption. And that's probably why it's gone down to 0.7 versus the 2 or whatever, is because his guy is now over here in Lingual. But I think right now getting our control up is going to be better. Because here's the thing, if I move away, we're still, if I move him out, that military presence, we're going to be at 0. And we're not taxing this province. And we have this as control plus 10. So, what I really need to be doing is getting a building here for control. The tap room. See, what would be really nice is if I had Artois, because then I could actually get the tap room. And since it affects all adjacent provinces, it would affect, you know, this province. It would affect this province. It would affect this province. I don't really want to get it on the provinces that are on the coast, because it just doesn't help as much. But once again, there's not really much I can do, so we're just going to advance time. Kind of hoping he comes back this way. Okay, so he moved into Artois. Okay with that. Middleland, what do you want? I actually would like to trade with you. Yeah, hopefully that's what you want. Military access, sure. I would like to trade with you, though. That's going to... The Empire's probably not going to like that as much. And Lianne... Orcs are coming. Not too concerned, because they're way over there. Lord. We can now build, but I think, once again, I'm going to want to pick up a hero first. Plus 10 chivalry, plus 5 weapon. I would like someone that's going to leadership and chivalry. Chivalry melee defense, chivalry and weapon strength. Let's actually do the leadership, that's kind of nice. And recruit. Ready to serve. And I can't move you this turn now. So, leadership, chivalry, okay. Skills, I'm gonna wanna go with this. Controls increased by an additional 1, own province. Not bad. Then we don't want ambusher. We can control again, but we'll probably wanna do, wait, what? This one. Oh my gosh, that's way high. So I'm gonna have to actually get him in battle. Ugh. Okay. That kind of sucks, but that's okay. They're actually losing -2 control corruption. So now that he actually moved out of Lianne, the corruption's dropping significantly, which is gonna really help with my control. So we're just gonna chill here for a little bit. I do want to go crush that army. Although here's the thing, maybe I go crush that army and then I don't have to worry about this. Artois, we actually have agreements with, right? We can move through your land.
The laws of chivalry demand.
Yes.
I hear you.
You seek the lady's favor.
Plus 13. I think we're gonna do it. We're just gonna go try finding this army.
Warrior king.
And and we can't ambush at this point, so we're just going to chill right here. Now, are we losing control? No, we're still gaining control, and we're still losing corruption because I'm in the land and they're not. Cool. Next turn. So that was actually a good decision. Okay, yeah, you run away, little punk. I see where you're at, and I'm pretty sure I can come kill you. Now, Artois may be able to help me on this. He's attempting to lay ambush. I'm at 20 to 20. I would like to get him to come in. Maybe we just go for here. Assault units, 50% chance. 30% chance to assassinate. 1 in 3 or 1 in 50 to assault him. Whoops. All right, that's fine. Okay, he failed. That's fine. Hopefully, I don't know. At least he's in. He gained a little bit of level, it looked like. And now we're going to go. Oh, we can't kill you this turn. Crap. Okay, that's fine. Next turn. Control is fine, and corruption's fine. We are losing some happiness there, but he's at 86, so it's like, okay. Ooh, we're actually losing a lot over here. Why? Why are you losing all of a sudden? Taxes. Huh. What's your growth at? You got 10 more freaking turns, and then we can get another building. Although, I don't think I want to... I mean, the next building I need to do is the cellar. So really, we just need to come take over Marienburg sooner rather than later. Can I get through these mountains? Doesn't look like it. We have to flank this way. Artois, do you want to actually join war against? I wonder if you'd join my war. I bet he would. The lady grants you safe passage. So he still doesn't like the Confederation. And I wonder why. Like, they freaking love me right now. So, it's weird, because it's like, I don't know that they can love me anymore. So why won't they join me? Alright, whatever. Next turn. Aldahar. This is... Ooh? Oh, this is the dude that's just chilling right now. This is the guy that was from Lyonne. Okay, we want to reduce corruption, please. Control wouldn't be bad as well, but let's reduce corruption for now. And we're just going to knock the crap out of this corruption. Take it down to zero, please. Beastmen are going to try running away. No, they're actually going to attack me. I intercepted him. Okay, yeah, definitely. Cool. All right. So right now we have leadership plus 4 on the spearmen and arms. Do they have any large units? Chaos Warhounds, flying, spearmen. These guys all have stalk. Eek. But they don't have any large units, so I don't really need the leadership on you. Who would I like to not break then? I guess it doesn't really matter. We'll leave it on our spearmen then. Sure. By battle? Yeah. Okay. I'm trying to think. Am I missing something? I don't think I am. I think we're okay. I've not actually done this yet. Underground with the Beastmen fight. So they have Vanguard deployment, so we're going to want to move our units back just a little bit. We do have the range. I would like to get better range units. Ooh, crap. This is cool. This is freaking awesome. This is like a forest? Okay. I can dig that. Let's go ahead and gamble. Yeah! Ronald is with me. Start deployment. This is actually really kind of confusing because there's so much crap going on. Can we hit him from where he's at? No, we actually cannot. Their Vanguard deployment should only be to up here, though. So that should be okay. So I think we may just stay with where we're at. Except why are you pointed backwards? Alright. How about we point forward, guys? Just throwing that out there. Let's try it like right here. Then we have our archers in the front. Sweet. We're doing the flank. We literally cannot fit all our units in. That's hilarious. Like, look at all our cavalry. Oh, this is actually going to be kind of bad. We're not going to be able to really use our cavalry to flank and stuff like that. Okay. So let's think about this. Let us then bring you guys forward. And cover this flank. Spearmen, We're going to bring the spearmen here. Kind of help flank. Knights errant! Like, seriously, they're not going to be able to go anywhere. The map is, like, right here, so... Well, at least we don't have to worry about their Chaos Warhounds completely flanking around me and owning my dudes. That's going to be nice. Something like that, I guess. Sure. Although we should probably just put you guys straight away on triangles. And I guess we're going to do 2 and 2, then. 2 and 2. Same thing over here. We should probably put you on triangles. We'll put you up here. So we have 1, 2, and 2. Wait, what? You. Okay, let's do like that. 2, and then you back here. How about that? No. Why will you not turn? Okay, fine, whatever. Go stand on top of each other. Sure. You guys are over there. That's cool. You guys are over there. Cool. Let's get our units organized. We're doing 3, 4, 5, 1. Sounds good. Let's start the battle. And hopefully they're going to move towards me. They're not moving towards me. They are not going to move towards me? Huh. Let's bring you guys up. Let's put you on skirmish. Not guard mode. Skirmish mode. Let's see if we can bait them out. So the question is, here's the problem. Every time I freaking move the units, they're going to reorganize themselves. Because I don't know the freaking controls. You know what? Options. We're going to see if it's in the control settings. Camera left, battle. Select all artillery units. Oh, hey, I didn't know that was a thing. Group, ungroup. Special ability, toggle unit speed. Increase unit group's width. Ah, that's nice. Step unit group backwards. Rotate unit group, strafe group, left and right. Now, when you say left and right, are you talking left and right arrows? Path to selected units. About face, J. Huh. I kind of wish I would have looked at this a long time ago. So when you say left and right, Spurs, lads. Let's select all these guys. On to glory. Ah! By the lady. That's cool. Okay. So I'm using the arrow keys, FYI, if you're wondering what the heck I'm doing. And then we'll move you guys up to, like, right here. And so now we can move everything like that. We probably want you guys to come back because we don't need you quite that far. Something like, let's go actually to, like, right here. Let's do that. That's really freaking cool, guys. Oh, sorry. This has been a long time for me to actually figure this out. And let's then move you guys to about, like, right there or something like that. Sure. Okay, unpause. And I don't want anyone actually running. I gotta not use the arrow keys. 2. Don't run. Walk. 3. Walk. Although archers, I care less. If you guys wanna run, sure. What the heck happened here? You guys moved really fast. We're on speed 1? Okay. It seems really fast for speed 1, but okay. Especially since he's not running. Oh, he is running. Walk. It's like there's no reason to freaking run. I would like to get you in just enough range and then take some shots at him. We're slowly moving all our units forward. We're gonna be at the bottom of the hill, which is kind of a bad idea, but it'll be fine. Let's move you like here. Are you guys coming? Slowly but surely. All this freaking crap's in the way. At least where we're going is going to be a little more open for us to be able to, like, flank and stuff like that. we have you on skirmish and fire at will. So let's go take a shot at these guys. They do have a lot of ambushers, so we want to be a little careful. Yep, there we go. Discovered. Okay, run away. I mean, that's fine. It's just as long as you stay in skirmish mode, you're okay. How are my units going? Okay, actually, let's unpause. Let's run everyone forward now at this point. Our archers are pretty far away. Let's put our archers right up here. And these guys, what's your range at? Your range is good enough, so we're just gonna leave you up there. And then let's go 5. We want you guys to run. You guys are actually already in position? Ooh, okay. Let's go 5, and let's bring you guys forward. Something like that. They actually have archers that are shooting at me. You should be on runaway. You should run away. Okay. I was like, anytime now, you can run away. They have harpies. Gotta watch out for... Oh, you know who we didn't bring forward? These guys. Whoopsie. Oh, God. Did we bring one forward? We did. Why are you way up there? Come back. Come back. Come back. Come back. Come back. Where's she at? God, they're so fast. Oh, those are my units. I effed that up on so freaking hard. Okay. Their Chaos Warhounds are incoming. Let's go smash the crap out of them. I'd like to actually then put you guys up here. I don't need more than 2 units to take care of you. Hey, Pegasus Knights, go take care of their harpies. Let's get you through. Here's the unfortunate part, is I completely wasted that spell. Curse of the Midnight's negative melee. This is going to be melee attack, melee defense. Let's put it on here. Are you really attacking my harpies right now? That seems like such a bad idea. We're going to move you guys this direction. Okay. Come get them. Come get them. Come freaking get them. Come get them. Come get them. And you just kind of go squish. Actually, no. Squish these guys. Okay, so we're breaking them already. We have already broken one of their units. Oh yeah, they're decimated at this point. So their cavalry looks like they're breaking. Oh, those are the harpies. So yeah, come over here and squish their cavalry. Come do that, come do that. You guys go squish. Go squish. You know, I don't know where their hero is. By the way, we should probably be doing this. You are probably the most precarious. And then let's take this and put it like right here. Do you have anything? You have magical and missile resistance, so sure. You're squishing them. You're squishing them. At this point, let's go ahead and turn you off. And let's turn you off, because they pretty much are screwed. So I don't want to waste the rest of my... I don't want to kill my own units, I guess is my point. Is this their hero? This is actually their hero, who's at full life. So let's try killing him. You guys come kill those guys. Okay, so their hero is running away. I would like to kill their hero, if at all possible, so that they can't keep spawning. You guys are fine, you guys are fine. Are they the white? They are white. That's hard to see on that minimap. Do we have their hero flanked? Okay, so he is flanked, so he's gonna die. You guys are killing that. You guys are... God, this is so chaotic. I can't tell. This is such a weird map. Okay, you guys finished off, so come over here and try killing some of these dudes. There's this one unit running away. He's going to get out. So I don't think we're gonna be able to get to him in time. Yeah, that's a little on the disappointing side. That's fine. At least we'll go for their hero. And if we can kill him dead, I think the army disbands then at that point. So, Morgor, bad day for you. That's all I have to say. You can't do anything. You can. Let's go ahead and hex right here. And we'll just do that, and hopefully we get more damage. And hopefully he's going to take a lot more damage as well. So, if you guys are not doing anything, come kill this guy. Make sure he doesn't get away. And everyone else is gone at this point. They have like 2 units. So all we have left is the freaking hero. I don't like the fact that they're white. That's hard to see. I kind of wish I could have them selected. You know, kind of how we can see that? I wish I could have, like, you know, their icons over here so I can actually see some of their units, so I can see how well certain ones of their units are doing. That would actually be really nice to have. Give you a little better view of, oh, hey, their enemies are about to break, or, you know, their big dudes are actually kicking my ass, you know, or however it is. What's he riding? What's he look like? Can I even see him? I think this is him right here. Oh yeah, he's a creepy looking dude. We have like 600 guys surrounding him, it's hilarious. And I'm only slightly sarcastic when I say that. How close to the edge is he? He's got a ways to go. I think we're gonna get him. Let's speed it up. Why are we going speed 1? Please kill him. Please kill him. Please kill him. Any day now. Any day. Any day. Come on. Come on. He apparently has a lot of extra HP bonuses. There he goes. Woo! Good job. I don't know if we killed him or if we just wounded him. Either way, they brought 1,100 to the fight. I brought 1,000 to the fight, but my 1,000 were a heck of a lot better than theirs. I only lost 41. They lost 817. Wow, dude, my knights. See, that's the thing. You don't bring a lot of troops because the knights don't have, like, I mean, 45 in a unit versus 90. Yeah. We also got quite a few levels there, which is really, really good for us. Unfortunately, our men-at-arms aren't getting levels. Probably because they're not really fighting much. We need to take the leadership. We also killed off him. He'd die. Has been disbanded. So their whole army should be disbanded at that point.
You tread upon Bretonnian land. I'll have your will.
Petarvon.
Now.
Hi. Yes. And now that we can actually see you, we can actually maybe do some trading with you. So we got Winds of Magic plus 8. Ooh, that's nice. We also destroyed the Beastmen. Yeah, what's up? Wow, that was pretty disappointing. So we've destroyed the vampires and the beastmen over here. So all that's left is Bretonnian lands. That's pretty freaking awesome. Okay, so my hope is she got that Winds of Magic boost. The hedge wizard? Yeah, that's what it looks like. Ooh. Ah, Lauren actually reduces. Didn't realize that. Okay, sweet. How's everything looking over here? Going plus 6, going plus 6. Sounds good. One thing I want to do before we call this an episode is let's go ahead and trade with Paravon.
The laws of chivalry demand.
He won't trade anything. But, at least we have trade agreement going with him. Okay, cool. So we're going to wrap this episode up here. Things are going a lot better than they were, so I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, drop a like, go ahead and comment. Let me know what you guys think, and as always, hit the subscribe button. Join the game coming. Share your support. I'll see you guys next time. Bye.